Bucket.
But Alpo said he killed Rich at a light in Harlem. Then they drove to the Bronx to dump the body. So why is AZ telling this story? But he told the story before the first time on Vlad. But why is he telling this story? That Alpo did all this. So that means... And it wasn't a Suzuki truck. It was a MPV van. I think Mazda made them. Word. But the whole thing is, that means when, supposedly when Alpo stopped to talk to you after he killed Rich, after y'all got finished playing basketball, that means Rich was in the front seat dead. Rich was in the van dead, or the Jeep dead, whatever you say. You said it was a Jeep, but I believe Alpo when Alpo said it was a MPV van. So what are you talking about, A? Like, that means your man was in the front seat dead if that's what happened. Listen to Alpo.
Leave his body without
anyone seeing me and seeing the van or just so the only place I can think of and just driving and it's just so funny. I'm saying City Island, but I'm not even sure if I wanted City Island, but I just knew I wanted to get off the streets and get onto a highway.
How did you feel? Was you mad? Was you angry? Like, what was going on in your head?
I was very mad. I just killed a nigga that I loved. A nigga that I was getting money with. A nigga that I called my brother. We kept driving this way. And until I could find a remote spot to somewhere over here. So I pulled over like right here, just through the van up on the, as close as I can to the rail. Once I pulled over, my little man, he's probably about, Gary's probably like 5'3", 1 something, so I'm trying to stay behind the steering wheel. I'm trying to stay in the driver's seat just in case we gotta pull off and have him go dump the body. But when he went to go try to dump, you know, get Rich out of the car, he couldn't pick him up. He couldn't pick him up. Rich was bigger than him. So he couldn't move him to put him in the woods and all that. So now I had to get out of the van to go help him. And when I went to go help him, Richard made a sound. So that shit startled me. Oh shit, he's still alive. So I grabbed the gun. I grabbed the gun from my little man.
When Richard was when that was happening, Richard died. I don't understand that thing, but that's the way he felt. And again, that's just, I guess he feels better if he glorifies him, so. But let's keep it real now.
How did they get the idea that you killed Rich?
Huh?
How did they find out that you killed
Rich? I told them.
You told them?
I told him.
You told AZ?
Yeah, I told AZ I killed Rich.
Why'd you tell him?
I was on the phone talking to him and I said, I know you want to know.
So do you have it, man? My take on it is AZ's lying, man. Outpo wouldn't stop and pull over and talk to him after he killed Rich while Rich is in the car. That never happened. So that part that AZ's talking about, he heard the gunshots and all that, that never happened. That never happened because you just heard Outpo say he was in the car and he drove straight to City Island. So that goes to show you right there, somebody's lying. And I say AZ's lying. You know what I mean? Plain and simple. Because think about it. Put the stories together. It doesn't add up. So that means you heard a gunshot and they was inside a car. So you heard the gunshot playing basketball while he got shot in a car. That's possible. But AZ make it seem like the gunshot was in a hallway or something, and all that happened. He shot Rich in a fucking car, man. It's like, come on. You ain't making no sense, eh? Ain't making no sense. But it's Chinks Bundles, a.k.a. the Ghost of Outpo. I'll be back at you.